Larry Herb, Xbox Live's Major Nelson. Welcome to show number 639. Hello, Jeffrey.
Hello.
Joining me in the studio is Jeffrey.
That has been a while.
It has been a while. I was looking at the notes. The last one we did was before E3, which seems like a month plus ago because it was a month
plus
ago.
Spoiler alert, we survived.
Yeah, E3.
Thrived even.
I don't know if we need to talk about that at all. Should we? I
mean, it's in the past.
Yeah, it is in the past. They don't want to hear all the behind the scenes stories and the drama and the... There really wasn't any drama.
No. The most dramatic thing that happened was breathtaking appearances by celebrities.
I will tell this story. I have not told this story about Keanu before.
No.
We were, you know, so usually when there's a big celebrity involved, nobody knows. A lot of people did not know.
You told me about an hour before showtime.
Right. And I happened to be in this. They cleared everybody out of the Microsoft Theater, and we were in, I don't know what it was. Code double red or 51 or area 50. I don't know what it was. Anyway,
let's not get in area 51 because there's a lot going on there right now.
Anyway, the place is all locked down, and I was on the list to get in. So I'm sitting there and I totally forgot this moment, and he came out and he rehearsed. It was great. But the rehearsal version and what you saw live, completely different, because he got so much energy from the crowd and that you saw him put that energy right back in. I mean, he came out, he was great, he read the lines, he did what he was supposed to do, hit his mark, turned around, here's the trailer, walked off stage, yay.
But this is why we do it.
Yeah.
You know, you can record these things, you can just put them out there, but when you've got the crowd there
right.
interacting and,
right.
and the people on stage, we're doing it for the fans.
Right, right.
And when they're there reacting in real time, that's where the magic happens.
Yes, and that's what you saw. That's exactly what you saw. So anyway, we're having a great time. We had a great time. We've been a few weeks of travel. Just got back from London. The brand new Microsoft store opening at Oxford Circus.
It looks really nice. The elephants were there. The trapeze artists.
It's not that type of circus, Jeffrey. I know you live in Florida. You were from Florida.
You know, the Swap Shop had a free circus every day.
Did they?
They did.
And I know
if
that's
you
where,
lived in South Florida.
And I know that's Ringling Brothers used to have their summer, their winter home there.
I didn't see the Dumbo movie, but yes.
Right.
Or the one where Wolverine sings circus.
The Big Top.
I don't think
anyway,
that's
not that type of circus. This is, anyway, the store, if we're right, you come up the Oxford Tube line and we're right there.
Yeah. It is... Right across from the Nike Town.
Right across. That's right. You've been in the Nike Town. But it's a beautiful store. Stop by if you want to check out second floor gaming action. First floor, actually. Before we even get to the second floor, come into the store, go to the right. We have this incredible McLaren setup that our good friend Paul, who works at the store, has put this thing together where you get into the McLaren and it essentially is a motion. It's a motion simulator, and you're driving Forza.
But it's a real McLaren.
Right, and you're moving around inside of it. It's pretty extraordinary.
So I didn't get to go, which, you know, I'm not bitter. You know, London's only my favorite city in the world.
You don't like London. You certainly don't like football.
No, not in the slightest, and especially not Raheem Sterling, who was hanging out there.
He was really nice. We had a great chat.
Anyways, so what I had to do is sit at home and read The Verge, which had a really good... look inside. In fact, I should really look
closely. Is that from Tom?
To see from Tom Warren.
Yeah, I saw Tom. He and I had a great chat.
There's the people in the pictures. I'm like, oh, I know her. That's Sophie. Oh, there. No, honestly. Yeah.
Actually,
you're not in any of these, are you?
No.
But I'm going to link out to it because this is, you know, you may have been in a Microsoft store. If you're listening to the show, you've certainly visited one.
We've done a lot of
stuff in your town or when you've traveled to a place where there is one. And this is different. This is so much better. So I will visit next time I'm there. If you go all the way down to the picture,
we'll put a link
with
in the
flowers
show
and the three women. That's to say hi to Sophie.
Where can
she's
I say?
Nice. Right there, Sophie Densham. Right. Oh well. Anyway.
Oh yeah.
And Alice, Sophie, hi. And anyway, good people. Good people. We'll see them at Gamescom.
Well, you'll see them at Gamescom.
Oh yeah, that's right.
So anyway,
I'll link out to that store.
Microsoft store now open, Oxford Circus. It's one of our flagship stores, first one in Europe. I highly recommend check it out. The gaming expert there's a bunch of gaming experts up there. They're big gaming fans, so stop by and see them. They are just lovely folks, and they're all great people.
And you got to meet Peter Crouch as well, like the tallest football player in Premiership history.
Yeah, yeah,
he's tall.
Yeah, he is. Peter is huge. But yeah, go swing by the store, ask for Scott Zeal. He is the store gaming expert, good friend of mine,
nice.
And tell him I sent you. He used to be a lawyer.
Really? Well, now he's doing something fun.
Yeah, he didn't want to be a lawyer anymore. He wanted to work in the games industry, and he wanted to help people. And I was like, wow, he's
That's
a great guy.
I said
guy.
To my mom but I was like 12, and it didn't go over that well.
Jeffrey, you're going to be a lawyer.
You're going to be a lawyer. I'm going to play video games.
Jeffrey, you're going to be
mom.
A lawyer.
I showed you.
Yeah, well. All right, so we did. I did that before that. Jeff and I had the chance to go to Orlando for the Halo
Outpost Discovery.
Now, this is an amazing event. If you missed it in Orlando, don't worry. We're going to Philadelphia this weekend.
That's I can't
you're
wait
to be there.
By the time you listen to this, I should be in the city of brotherly love.
Yep.
And basically, it's a real life Halo experience. And this is the only one that's going to be in the Northeast. So if you're listening and you're somewhere in the tri-state area,
as we say, hop on Amtrak.
Yep. And head on over to downtown Philly to the Pennsylvania Convention Center.
Not
and
the plateau.
Come on by. That's where everybody go. If you're going to drop a line on me, like I was doing this in warm ups, it's not going to get past me. I'm going to stop them all. And essentially, you get to, at various times, like, be a Spartan.
Yeah.
I would say be Master Chief, but none of us is 7 feet tall. We should have Peter Crouch out there. He could be the closest we could get there. I'll just start with my favorite thing, which is this VR experience, which is a 3-on-3 competitive shooter.
It's called Training Grounds.
Called Training Grounds. Thank you very much. And this is the best VR experience I've ever had, and I've had quite a few.
We don't want to spoil it, because for those of you going to Philadelphia, and there's other locations. The other locations, we've got Houston, we've got Chicago and Anaheim.
Yeah.
This is an incredible VR experience that for the first time, you will feel like you are in a Halo game.
Yep. Untethered.
On Valhalla.
Oh, very good.
You're on Valhalla. The play space is kind of at the top in the center. If you remember in Valhalla, which is one of the maps from Halo, that's been remade a few times in the Halo universe. You're kind of in the middle, that middle area where the man cannons would drop you off, or you'd land up there. You know, the Pelican is off on the left and so forth. So, but you get in there and you're playing, as Jeff said, 3v3 with plasma pistols.
And you look down at your hand. There's a plasma pistol. It behaves exactly as you think it was.
It vibrates.
If you hold it, it charges up for a charge shot, or you can tap it rapidly. You look over and you look at your teammates, and there are other
Spartans
next to you, and they're red or blue. You choose your side, and then you go.
Great.
I mean, came out of that just so enthused. And it's funny, a lot of the things you do in games, like crouch run, a lot harder in real life.
Yeah, they sure are.
I was sore.
There's a lot to do, and we'll certainly put a link out to Halo Outpost Discovery. Training Grounds, the VR experience, is one. The other one we had a lot of fun with was Combat Deck.
Yes, and that is like a Halo meets laser tag.
That's exactly what it is.
And so if you've played laser tag before, you're shot, you're out. Okay, that's not what this is. So you have an assault rifle, assault rifle in your hands, and it makes the sounds. So when you get a kill, it lets you know. And when you're shot, it's not immediately dead. You hear the shields go down, and then you go into cover and you wait for the shields to recharge before making another move. It got very heated and very strategic very quickly.
And of course, if you are taken out, then you have to go back to the respawn area.
Yeah, you respawn and you come back out again.
Come back, you gotta reload.
You know what? In real life, respawn campers it's something you have to deal with.
Now, I do, if I recall correctly, I did get the drop on you a few times.
You did.
In
you
real
did.
Life. You and I were on different teams.
We were on different teams by request. And I requested it. And you did get me first, and I did get you last.
I was like, so we traded. But it was good. It was mutuals.
Yep.
So that's a lot of fun. Of course, Combat Deck, the target range is there, the ring experience.
Yeah, just a very cool experience that sort of takes you through the story of Halo.
Right.
But if you've ever been to a combination of like an IMAX and a planetarium, but you feel like you're moving.
Yeah.
Really enjoyed that. It's Halo come to life.
Yeah.
And there's people that make Halo from 343, people, voice actors from Halo that you would know, wandering around. There's autograph sessions. There's play sessions that are happening live.
There's like-minded fans.
You got up there and you played on stage with fans.
Yeah, we had a great time. Our good friend Rob from Minneapolis.
Yeah,
Reclaimer
Rob. Always good to see him.
Yep.
You know, I didn't know he was from Minneapolis. He comes out to everything we do. I just assumed he lived here.
No, he was. So he Pelican Training, which is an escape room, Covenant Escape. We've got a streaming area.
Oh, and if you've never gotten a chance to play Halo Fireteam Raven,
yes,
you can sit down. You can play through the whole game.
Yeah, that's the stand-up cabinet that's at a lot of the Dave and Buster's.
Exactly, which is very fun.
Yeah,
and spend a lot of time there. Cool merch. It's just, if you like Halo, you should be there. Simple.
We'll put a link in the in the description below, or in the show below. We've got Philadelphia's this weekend, and then Chicago's coming up in early August. Yep. Mid August is Houston, and then Anaheim wraps it up at the end of August/early September. So we'll have all the details there. It's really a must see. And Jeff, you and I kicked off Orlando. I don't know if I'm going to be able to get to any of the other ones. Maybe I'll go to Houston, or I've never been to Houston, so maybe I should go there. Actually, maybe I have, or maybe Anaheim. But either way, I recommend you guys check it out. So
yeah, I'll be there this weekend. Try and track me down. Find me if you can. I mean, maybe we'll all go for cheesesteaks. That would be fun.
I insist you go for cheesesteak.
All right.
So
done and done.
Now that you have your phone back, you can take Instagrams.
Are we going to talk about that, Larry?
I'm happy to talk about
it. We can save it for the gear section.
Well, we'll save it for that, so we'll revisit this. Let's back up a little bit and rewind, jump back what we're playing, what's going on, et cetera, because there's been a lot of games going on and a lot of playing.
It's backlog season. It's a good time. I'm making up for the games that, you know, while we were at E3, there was sort of a bit of a blast radius where I didn't have a chance to play a lot of stuff during that time.
Yep.
And I'll tell you, the game that has really caught my eye, aside from Apex, we're playing a lot of Season 2.
Yep.
The wins are coming fast and furious. I think when all the good people are in the ranked games right now,
yes,
and
they are.
They're leaving it, I'm like a wolf in the hen house right now in Apex, I got to tell you. A Plague Tale, Innocence.
Yeah.
So this is a game that came out, I want to say it was in May. If you saw a game with a lot of rats, this game has more rats, mm-hmm. pound for pound, than any game in history. Yeah.
In fact, if you look in the back of the box, it says more rats than any game.
It is. It's that was the quote by
Earl Dittman.
Earl Dittman. Thank you. all these things make a lot more sense if you had lunch with us today. Right. But anyway, it's a game that takes place during the Hundred Years' War between France and England, which also was concurrent with the Black Plague. It is an action stealth game where just imagine trying to get out of that situation where you have just hordes of rats that are feasting on all of the dead. I mean, it's pretty gruesome. There's no way to really sugarcoat that. Or the different groups of either French or English troops that are in the area that don't take kindly to strangers.
Yep.
And it is thrilling at times. There are scenes where you're just running for your life. There's times where the thing I like about a stealth game is I don't like it when you're seen and it's instant fail. And I also like when there's a lot of different ways to, you know, here's a situation.
Right.
There's a couple guards here. There's
a clay pot over here.
There's some fire there. There's something that could drop on someone's head if I time that out right, but then the other person will notice. I have a lot of tools at my disposal.
Puzzle.
That is this game. There's so many different ways to get through. And sometimes I do things and I'm like, I don't think that the developers would have guessed that you could get through this way.
Right.
And I mean, I'm sure they did, but you know, it doesn't feel like there's only just one way to get through a lot of these puzzles, especially later in the game. So I highly recommend you check it out as
a student of innocence. History.
It really brings this era to life. Like you've heard about the plague. You may have heard about the Hundred Years War.
Is this in Game Pass? I can't remember.
It is not part of Game Pass.
It is not part of Game Pass. Okay.
It is made by Asobo Studio out of France.
Ah, that's right.
But it really is bringing what a tough time this was to be alive and a tough place to be alive. Really brings it to life in a really cool way. And I can't say enough about it, but I've probably said enough about it.
Plague Tale Innocence, check that out. When I'm playing, speaking of Game Pass, Outer Wilds, which I keep going back to, which
is... Have you finished it yet?
I haven't finished it yet. In fact, I am just having so much fun going around the solar system, landing on the planets, discovering... Every time I go there, I discover something different. And I don't know, did we talk about this?
I don't know that we've had a chance to talk about this on the show.
So the game is... You wake up, you're on a planet, a tiny planet, and you have to go explore the universe to see what's going on, the solar system to see what's going on. And it's 22 minutes?
22 minutes.
22 minutes, and at the center of this particular solar system is a large sun. And the sun goes supernova, i.e. it melts down every 22 minutes. And you can tell because you look at it and it gets darker.
I'm just going to read a headline here.
Please.
From Kotaku that hit end of June. Outer Wilds is one of the best games I've ever played.
Yeah. That's it. So
that for that type of game to be in Game Pass is pretty darn cool.
So you play the game, and you basically take off. You go to different planets. You explore, and as you discover things, your ship log gets updated. You can go back to your ship in your spacesuit, and after 22 minutes, the solar system basically blows up, and you wake up again. But your ship log still has all the data in it. So you have to essentially think of the 22 minutes as like a save point.
Yeah, in a way. And, right. and really the progress that you make, this isn't a game where you level up. This right. isn't a game where you're collecting weapons.
Right.
This is a game where you're
not looting.
You're learning more each time. And so when the sun goes supernova, you're not upset about it. You're not supposed to beat it in that first
you
22
can.
Or even, yeah.
Maybe you impossible. Can. I don't know. Is that anybody a speed run?
I mean, maybe it's possible. I don't know. But it's a game where you're figuring it out, you're unwinding a mystery of this ancient race that came before you. It's
yep.
pretty interesting stuff.
So there you go.
Another game I've been playing that's on Game Pass that I got very into in the last couple of weeks is Kingdom Two Crowns.
Oh.
So it's a side-scrolling pixel art sort of like strategy, like real-time strategy game, I guess I would say. You're a king on a horse, and you go through, and basically you, by investing coins in different places, you recruit troops, you train them to be either builders or archers or later knights and other things. You build up a town, and it's all horizontal, and then so you build during the day, and then at night these sort of monsters come and they try to break down your walls and steal all your stuff.
Right.
And so it's this sort of push and pull, and it's really interesting. And a lot of it is about making sure you don't overextend. And then at the right time, investing money to build a ship and explore to another island. Ultimately, you want to wipe out these bad guys come from this like really big portal, this sort of monstery looking thing. And you learn more, you get better mounts, and you're able to recruit better soldiers and things like that. And you sort of go on these expeditions, but there's like real feelings of loss when, you know, I'm making a daring run. I think we can take these things out, and we didn't do it. And then I've got to sort of figure out, all right, how could I have done this better?
Mm-hmm.
Or did I not cover my rear guard or anything like that? If you kind of like strategy, but certain strategy games, certain RTSs are a little too complicated. There's just left and right. So you really don't have nearly as much to worry about and focus on. And yet it still manages to be deep at the same time.
Yep.
So highly recommend Kingdom Two Crowns. And again, as part of Xbox Game Pass. So you've got nothing to lose.
Speaking of Game Pass, on the PC side, for those of you that have PC Game Pass or Xbox Game Pass.
Or Game Pass Ultimate.
Right, Game Pass Ultimate. When I was down, I hate saying this, but because please don't think this is,
I don't know where you're going
call
with this,
it a
but
flex or a weird name drop. So I was down talking to Phil yesterday.
That's
Phil
bit
Spencer.
Of, bit of a flex.
No, it's not. I mean, I talk to him all the time. He and I are chatting. He's playing Battle Chasers Night War, and he wants me to check that one out. And that
okay.
one's on. I need to check that out. So
there's a lot of new game. There was another game that actually just hit Game Pass PC. I'm like bringing up the app right now. Slay the Spire.
Right.
It's a game that had gotten some just stellar reviews. And apparently it's like the single player card battler game for people who think they don't like card battling
right,
games.
Right.
And you know, I'm going to go ahead and I'm just going to hit install while I'm here.
You're doing
on my
that
laptop.
Right now. On the air. We're doing
on
it
air,
live.
Doing it live. And I'll give that a shot while I'm on my flight out to Philly. So sorry, email. I will not be checking you. I'll be checking out Slay the Spire, which just came to Game Pass on last month.
Another game that I am playing, I just was playing it earlier this week, Sea of Solitude from EA.
That one looked really cool.
Yeah, it looks, one of those what's going on in the world and discover it and whatnot. So I just had a little, you have to swim and get swallowed or not.
Or not.
But there's a lot going on there. So Sea of Solitude is a lot of fun. So playing a lot of different things as you
were. That's what's great about this time of year. Now we're going to have so many cool things, you know, coming up later, like Gears 5. There's actually a Gears 5 versus beta that's coming, or alpha that's coming up in the next weekend.
That's right.
And if you have Game Pass, you're in that.
You're in. Didn't you know? You're in.
You didn't know.
Hello, Game Pass subscriber. Thank you.
Actually, just since we're talking about that, the Gears 5 tech test included in your Xbox Game Pass membership, you will be the first to play Gears 5, and it is, you'll be able to contribute to the future of versus multiplayer. Note that you will need Xbox Live Gold. Of course, if you have Xbox Game Pass Ultimate, you have Gold. You're all set already.
You're there.
And so look forward to that coming up.
There's a, speaking of backlog, apparently I have a large backlog.
It's not a backlog, Larry. It's a back forest.
Earlier this week, I was chatting, because it was Prime Days for Amazon, and I was posting about, they had a lot of deals on storage. So if you needed to increase storage for your Xbox, you know, you could just use any USB 3 device that pretty much anything. I was linking off, and people were like, well, how many, you know, what do I need? How many games do you have? And I posted my games and apps area, and it started. And so that was on Twitter, and then somebody copied and posted it over on Reddit, and it's got a life of its own over there.
Well, I do like the Xbox One subreddit. It's a lot of good stuff.
Oh, there's great people over there. I think I've got I had 729 games installed, ready to install 837. There's a lot of them. Yeah, so a lot of if you want to go over and take a look at that thread, but yeah, there's a lot to play right now. Overwatch this morning, they announced some stuff.
Oh, yes. Summer Games is coming back for, wow, is this the fourth year?
I think it is. Games? Yeah.
We're getting old, Larry.
We are, Jeff.
I feel like Overwatch has grown up before our eyes.
Do you remember when?
I do, actually.
The next thing
I remember playing the beta before it came out.
The next thing we know, it'll be in the Tonight Show studios.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, it is.
It is, yes. we have to go to an Overwatch
I've never
League
been.
Game.
You've been there twice and I've not been.
Yeah. We should do that this
Down
summer. It's really, really worth going to. Right? They've been doing a lot of cool thing where they go from city to city. I know they were in
Is
Atlanta
Is the Star
recently.
Still down there? Where Johnny used to stand?
I don't think so.
Okay, that's that.
Well, I don't know if Johnny was in that studio. I know Leno was in that studio. I don't know if they were in the same studio.
Okay.
We're talking about Overwatch League where they tape. Or it's not taping because it's live.
Right.
Incredible setup there. But they have been going city to city. And the final is in Philly this year at the end of the summer. I forget exactly
when
it is.
You're
going
to go back to Philly?
We'll have to see. I think it's very close to PAX. And then we have Gamescom. So there's a lot of stuff going on around that time. But if not, I mean, I always look for an excuse to go back.
Right.
And God knows the Phillies are not giving me that excuse. Yeah. So Overwatch.
Mm-hmm.
We should play that. If we can tear ourselves away from Apex.
Yeah, that's something.
I like the Watson. Change the game.
She is changing the game. I'm sorry, I'm looking. I totally forgot that we are roughly plus or minus, depending upon when you think the anniversary is, we're right about the 50th anniversary of the moon landing.
Yeah, I know, that's coming up.
Which is a big deal.
How was it, Larry? You were there.
Oh, ha ha. I did not step on the moon. I was cut from that squad. I don't know. I was just thinking about what a moment that is that we haven't been back to the moon in so long.
I know. Well, we got a rock. We hit a golf ball on it.
We drove
a car on it. What else do you do?
We couldn't be more American.
We ordered a burger.
We drove around. We stole something and we left. So lovely. Yep. Oh yeah. Anyway. I don't know what maybe brought that up. I guess there was a headline that caught my eye. But yeah.
Next up is Mars. Actually, I've been playing Surviving Mars, which is
segue.
I can't believe we brought that one back.
Yeah, well done.
Which is a really cool strategy game. It's a lot deeper than I initially expected. So, all right, if Kingdom Two Crowns is sort of your very basic, I don't play a lot of strategy games, but I'm interested. That's on one end. On the far end is Surviving Mars, which
right.
had a 6-part tutorial, but it's really interesting. It's kind of Sim City. There's a lot of things happening in real time though, and you're constantly balancing out. Yeah, it's definitely more Sim City, but you're exploring Mars at the same time as you're making it
right.
habitable for your humans. You'll be playing for hours before you can even get humans onto the planet,
right?
Because you have to basically start from making so you can mine oxygen and water and all these other things. But it's really well done, and it runs on a variety of I've been playing on my work laptop, just a Surface laptop, which I'm a huge fan of. It's not a gaming PC by any means, but I'm able to run certain games off of Game Pass, like no big deal, which is really cool, including Surviving Mars.
So you're gonna play that one? On the plane?
I'm going to play a little bit of Slay of the Spire. It's a long ride. It's 5 hours out, 6 back. So
I know.
Plenty of time to play lots of games.
Yeah, you do. You have plenty of time.
A lot of emails I'm going to have to ignore on that flight out.
It's funny. I was going to play a little bit on the plane when I was coming back from Orlando, but I ended up, was it Orlando or London where I watched that movie? Last Breath. Have you heard about this movie?
No.
So as a scuba diver, of which I am, of which you are not,
no, thank you.
And I've tried to convince you.
I don't like going past my knees.
And it is one of the most horrifying films. It's a true story. And it's a horrifying film. And I actually had to stop watching it. It's about commercial divers, guys that work like on oil
welding
wells.
And yeah, things like
on,
that.
On oil wells. Yeah. You have to go down to fix things and things unfortunately go wrong.
No, thank you.
It is. I was watching on the plane. I was like shaking. I stopped and had to get up out of my seat and walk around the plane. Cause I was like, I started having.
Even just thinking about being out there in open water. Just
I mean,
just
these guys are down
me.
Thousands of feet and I've only gone to, I think my max is 108.
Were going to go diving down in Orlando, weren't you?
Yeah, I was. It's one of my favorite dives to do is over at Disney's Epcot Center at the
Lagoon.
It used to be called Living Seas. I don't know what it's called now. Yeah. But yeah, you can go diving in there every day. If you're a certified diver, you can pay them and you go diving and you play around in there. It's a lot of fun.
Everyone's watching you?
Yes, I wanted you to come so you could see me diving.
That would have been cool.
And you would have been, you would have waved me off as you took your next drink at the bar.
I mean, in all likelihood, I'm like, I can see him scoffing.
Yeah, next. Yeah. How did we get to that? I don't know.
That's a good question.
All right, let's get back to those headlines, shall we?
All right. Well, let's talk about, we'll tie a bow on Game Pass because there's some new games that were just announced this week that are coming soon to Game Pass. And one of them, Metal Gear Solid 5, The Phantom Pain, Resident Evil 4.
Yes.
So both of those are coming to console. RE4. That's such a classic.
Yep.
Killer Instinct Definitive Edition. It's coming both to console
and PC.
Same thing for the Banner Saga 3. I actually beat Banner Saga 2.
Well done.
Thank you. Right when I got back from... I'd started it when it first came out back in like 2016 because I looked back at the achievements. I unlocked the first one in 2016 and I finished it in 2019. But really got into that. And so I definitely want to see how it ends in Banner Saga 3 and I'll be able to do that coming soon. And then a couple of games coming just to PC, if you've got that Xbox Game Pass for PC or Ultimate, Night Call and For the King.
For the King!
Yes, For the King. That was one we announced at E3, if I recall correctly.
Those are now available on Game Pass. So
check. And then once again, that Gears 5 tech test beginning on July 19th.
Now, if you're thinking about all these games and what's going on, but wait, we have more. It's called the Xbox Super Game Sale.
Oh, yes.
Yeah, we're putting a lot of games are on sale. It's the first ever Xbox Super Game Sale. It's going on now until the 29th of July. You can save up to 70% on more than 700
games.
Digital games and add-ons.
So. There's deals, 3 months of Game Pass Ultimate for the price of 1 month. There is also some like PCs. A lot of gaming PCs are on sale as well from Dell, Lenovo, Razer. Actually, kind of interested in that Razer, so I may have to take a look at that. The Samsung HM head-mounted display Odyssey, which is a VR headset with controllers, HyperX gaming accessories, of course, Xbox One S. I've seen a lot of Xbox One deals floating around at a number of different retailers this week. So there's a lot of that, and I just went through, I always like to see what games are on sale and like what's like the best deal out of all of them, and I'll provide my opinion. Deus Ex Mankind Divided.
Oh, I love that game.
Huge fan of that one. $4.49.
So that is less than the price of one of your fancy coffees.
That sad but true.
Mm-hmm.
And it is worth more than a cup of coffee, even at 7 in the morning.
Mm-hmm.
So if you played Human Revolution, it was the sequel to Human Revolution, which came out on the Xbox 360, which was a phenomenal game, and I believe is backward compatible, but I'd have to double check that.
Yep.
Deus Ex Mankind Divided was the sequel to that. Plays like you can, another game where you can play it any way you want. I like usually playing as a hacker. You know, this is what I would say. If you were excited by what you saw in Cyberpunk and you can't wait for Cyberpunk, I can't wait for Cyberpunk. You gotta wait till, I have to wait till what, April 22nd
whatever
of next year?
Out, yeah.
I think it was. This is very much in that vein. Plus you have Adam Jensen. No one's got a deeper voice.
Let's be clear though. There is no Keanu.
There is no Keanu.
Okay.
Well, there is an actor in this that's famous. I can't remember. It's been a little while since I played. But I did beat it a few years ago and I really enjoyed this game. So for $4.49, I'm going to link out to that. You can't beat that
$4.49.
And then Life is Strange, the complete, if you never played the first season, the whole season, all 5 episodes, $3.99.
Yep.
I'm looking for deals for you folks.
So good.
Deals. Oh, Metro 2033 Redo is $4.99. There's some really good deals in here. So we'll link out to the whole deal, the whole shebang, but specifically to Deus Ex, because I want you to play it.
Yeah.
I like it.
Busy time. It's you know, with all the games, it's backlog season. We're almost, and unfortunately, we're not going to have enough time because we're going to turn around and eventually we're going to be right back into, like you and I talked about in the industry. It feels like roughly around the time the next Madden comes out.
That's when it kicks off
the holiday.
Exactly, and then it's basically from Madden to Thanksgiving
is a bit of a
sprint.
Yeah.
Right. And oh man, very excited for some of the games coming out this fall. The Star Wars game just looks phenomenal. It was a Fallen Order.
Right.
Really into the new NBA. Oh, that was another thing.
Oh, he's back, ladies and gentlemen. You know him, you love him.
NBA 2K20.
Jeffrey Dean Chameleonaire.
I can't wait to remake him in every game.
Yes, you do.
So on the cover is Anthony Davis this year, new to LA.
I need you to stream it.
You want me to stream
when
it?
You're creating the
content creation? Yeah. Okay, we can do that. There is an Xbox One that is made specifically in celebration of it, and it has like this candy paint look to it. Kind of looks like there's certain shoes that it sort of looks like the bottom of that. It's anyway, my words do not do it justice, but I will link out to that as well. And that is something that a special NBA 2K exclusive Xbox bundle that well, it would look really good in my living room.
Would it?
It would. It would.
I'm sorry. I'm just looking through here to see if we have any. There's just so much that's come out, and you and I have been off the air for quite some time.
Is there anything you left out that you wanted to talk about? You've been playing.
It's no. I mean, those are really what I've been playing. Because of the travel and et cetera, and now we're in the summer, and in the Northwest, it tends to get tends to be nice. So we want to go outside and enjoy the outside. I know you actually had a lovely time outside, didn't you? On the water.
So I'm the proud owner of a new iPhone XR.
Let's talk about what happened.
Yeah. So, you know, like you said, and I think you see this in places like Scandinavia or Iceland. We don't get a lot of nice weather. Even now in the summer, I mean, it was kind of rainy and like 65 yesterday. So if we get sun, we try and take it.
Right.
And I was out on the lake.
Right.
Lake Union.
Yeah.
Union Bay. You ever heard of that? Those jeans from the 90s? It must be named after that. And so we're out there paddling, doing some outrigger canoe paddling. And at some point, I just reached for my phone because we saw a bald eagle. You get nature out here.
Yeah, you do.
And
on Lake Union?
Oh, yeah. We kind of like went through the cut to Lake Washington.
Right.
And over by the University of Washington, the Huskies football stadium. And there's eagles out there. It's really cool. And so I reached for my phone and it's not there. But it was there earlier because at one point I felt it just slipped out like just right into the sea.
Now split screen to me at my house,
and I'm like
and so I'm texting Jeffrey, as I often do. He and I talk all the time, and I see on Instagram that hey, do you want to play some Apex? And I get green bubbles. And for those of you that have iPhones, you know what green bubbles means. It means that they're not online, their phone's gone, or they're on an airplane. I was like, he's not traveling anywhere. This is weird. And I see, I'm like, I wonder what he's up to. I go to Instagram and I see that the last one was of you
basically getting on the boat.
And so I messaged, did you get the message on Instagram finally?
I did.
And I said, hey, water and electronics make me nervous. You need a floating phone case. I have one as somebody who does, we talked earlier, who dives. I said, you really need to, and sure enough, apparently I sent
it. It was your fault.
I cursed it because things went south.
It wasn't enough to suggest it. You needed to be right. And somehow you nudged the phone out of my pocket into the
universe in that direction.
I know.
I was worried.
It was the butterfly effect at work.
It was
one Instagram across the world and just, to knock a phone out of my pocket and into 30 feet of cloudy water.
Or 40 or 50. We just don't
all I know,
know
is I tried to find my iPhone. It could not find it. So it was deep.
Help
it was deep.
Me, help me.
So that was
oil.
That was an expensive Saturday. And then I went and saw Spider-Man, which made me feel better.
Oh, I didn't know that.
It's good.
Okay.
It's a good movie. Last thing I meant to mention, by the way.
Yes.
Games with Gold.
Oh, Games with Gold.
So hopefully you picked up Castlevania Symphony of the Night. That was July 1st through the 15th. But for the rest of the month, July, Inside, which I'm sure you played.
Yeah.
Kind of a twist in that one. So if you haven't played it, you should play it.
Check it out.
Meet the Robinsons is available from the 16th to the 31st of July.
Yep.
And then from now all the way until mid-August, Big Crown Showdown.
So good.
Showdown. Anyway, so those games are waiting for you to just just take them.
Yeah, so we wanted to get in the studio because we hadn't been in here for a while, so that's why we wanted to sit down with you and give you kind of an update. But we are, I think this is the quickest we're ever going to turn a show. We're actually going to do another show. We're going to go back into the mixer studio next week.
We should do that.
Yeah.
Our voices, our faces.
Really take away from the whole experience.
Oh, my God.
It's
what people want to see. Do you have any special guests lined up?
I'm working on a few, but just keep an eye on my Twitter, at Major Nelson, and I'll let you know when we're going to do it. Probably do it early to midweek is when the plan is.
I wonder, what should we do visual? Should we take a bunch of photos at Halo Outpost this weekend?
You should do that.
Do a slideshow.
You know what? Hit me up on Twitter and let me know what you want to see.
Yeah,
hey, could we make your Jeffrey Dean Chameleonaire then? Will you have a copy of the game?
I don't think it's out this early.
Okay.
That would be fun.
Right?
We'll do that. Let's do that. Usually come out, I think, in September, give or take.
Yeah.
So I'm actually looking it up right now.
Yeah. So we'll do something. We want you to join us. We haven't done
October 5th.
We haven't done a lot.
Right?
Really?
No, that was NBA 2K11. Anyway, it's not out yet.
Yeah, we're going to
September 6th.
We'll figure out what we're going to do. So we're going to do head over to Mixer. We haven't been on that since E3, actually.
I feel like there's almost like it's just a pivot point for the whole year.
Yeah.
It's the kickoff for the year.
Yeah, it's kickoff. It's a lot for things. So we're going to come back your way. But hey, we wanted to jump in the studio and do something, and that's kind of all I have right now. You and I got to get back to work. We got a bunch of stuff we're working on. Mm-hmm. Gamescom. Now, I'm not going to Gamescom this year. I'm not scheduled. You're going to head over there.
That's
plan. You have some other work to do. So they're going to.
Yeah, my day job.
You're going to do we're going to have some stuff going on over at Gamescom. And then we've got some other stuff. We've got the Gears launch going on. We're working on our PAX panel. We've got EXO later this year. Yeah, it's incredible when you start scheduling things out. And I say this every year, but I'm going to say it again. I saw some people that were in E3 meetings for next year already.
What?
Yeah.
It never stops.
It doesn't. It is just, it's this conveyor belt of craziness. So, but that's why we work here, because we love games. We love talking to everybody. We love the community. And certainly we love you guys for listening to the show.
Yeah. Thanks for listening.
Yeah. So we're going to wrap it up here. So we'll see you hopefully next week. Keep an eye on my Twitter at Major Nelson. Of course, if you want to see us this week on Xbox, airs every Thursday on your console, either on there. Sometimes Jeff is there.
Occasionally.
Yeah.
I did it last week.
Swing in your new your roller skating jacket.
It was the bomber jacket from gear.xbox.com.
Let's be very clear. Bomber, B-O-M, not Balmer.
No.
Okay.
Yeah.
So I want to make sure we understand what's going on there. But we'll see
you a Balmer jacket.
We'll see you guys next week. Thank you for downloading.
See you in Philly.
Maybe you'll see Jeff in Philly. Follow him at Jeff Rubenstein on Twitter. Also, if you have any complaints or feedback, send them his way.
You always do.
And if you have any lovely things to say, you can always send them my way. So there you go.
That's how it works. Or summon you on Reddit.
All right. We'll talk to you guys later, and we'll see you next week. Bye, everybody.